Well, do you have fall allergies or could you have COVID-19? Dr. Joseph Brunworth is a slew care otolaryngologist. He joins us this morning and he explains the difference in the symptoms. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Morning, Kim.
Well, first, let's get to it. What are the overlapping symptoms first?
Okay, well, you could have congestion that could be found in both COVID-19 as well as allergies. You could have postnasal drip, like runny nose, even cough. Some patients get a cough variant of their allergies. So there's quite a few that overlap.
So now tell us, what are the differences?
Well, even though you have some symptoms that overlap with coronavirus and allergies, you're going to look for things that are typical for you at that time of the season. If you get a runny nose, itchy eyes, itchy nose, sneezing, those sorts of things at this time of the year, I wouldn't be too worried. However, if you're getting more of the fatigue, cough, fevers, loss of sense of smell, or things that you don't typically get, then I think it's time to get evaluated for coronavirus.
And of course, those are the symptoms that a lot of people that we here at Channel 2 tell everyone to look out for, to go ahead and get tested. But some people, they have mild symptoms. When should they get tested? How do they know to go get tested?
There's a recent study out. This just came out. So I'm not sure if this is going to pan out or not. But some people are finding that in patients that are asymptomatic or minimally symptomatic, they find that they actually have lost their sense of smell to peppermint and coconut oil. So there's a little test you could do at home. Check to see if you still can smell peppermint and coconut oil. If you have mild symptoms that started suddenly and include loss of sense of smell or fevers or a significant cough and with malaise being that ill feeling that we get when we get a cold or flu, then I think it's still worthwhile getting tested.
So for those people who say, if they've been tested before, they're like, I just don't want to get that swab. I mean, I just can't. What would you say to them in order to push them to go ahead and get tested?
It's not a comfortable swab. It only takes a few seconds. I recently had a patient that was seeing me for congestion. They were booked weeks in advance, but 2 days prior to the visit, they ended up losing their sense of smell. And they thought, well, it must be with the same sinusitis that they see me for, that sort of thing. And we ended up saying, look, if you lost your sense of smell 2 days ago and it was sudden like that, we really should test you. So we did. She got the swab and sure enough turned out to be positive. Luckily, she was able to quarantine after that and her kids were doing home learning. And so they were also able to quarantine. But it can be scary for people, but just have to brave it for a few seconds and then you know you're safe.
I know, just stick it out for a few seconds and then you'll know what to do after that. We will have a link to slewcare.edu/healthwatch on fox2now.com. Dr. Brunworth, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.